Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Damn Music Show. It is about damn time that Darren and I actually got back and done did do something, Darren.
Yeah.
We ain't done did do for a little bit.
We've been busy with life stuff.
We took a done did breather for a second, but if there was anyone who could bring Darren back to watching and listening to the beautiful thing we call music and video, it would only be Taylor Swift. Darren, what level of excitement are you right now knowing the onslaught of really comments, lovely supportive comments and criticism
from the Swifties
that will likely be flung your way?
Yeah.
Darren, are you excited right now? Are you pumped? Are you stoked?
Oh, I love you, Swifties. You guys are reasonable, rational, level-headed people.
Passionate.
Critiquing, fair-minded, unbiased critiquing so well.
Well, if that's not biased, I don't know what is. All right. Well, we've also got none other than somebody. Well, just so we know, people, I like Taylor. I also like this other artist, Darren. You like this other artist, too?
Yes.
You like?
This is called Fortnite. I have no idea what it's about. You don't know what it's about. I guess this is not the video game.
Do you think it's about something that happens inside of 2 weeks?
Yes, or started 2 weeks ago.
Okay, here we go. Let's have a watch.
It's how long Taylor dated Post Malone.
He'd be lucky. I don't think that's true, actually.
Ooh, bondage.
One way. I think she's in a crazy house, Darren.
Oh, cool.
Functioning.
Right where
alcoholic.
She belongs.
That's going to do it, Darren. That'll send it.
A trigger.
Well, little helpless victim, Darren, again.
Great set design. She looks like Post.
I see what's coming.
What'd you say? I want to what? Kill
her? She said kill her.
Oh.
And I assume that is the other female.
Yep.
Posty. I took the miracle, move on drug. The effects were temporary. Is that Ozempic?
Yeah.
Oh, the miracle move on drug. Sorry, I'll be quiet. I touched you for only a
fortnight. That sort of surreal introduction
cool.
of color, very, very
super
Taylor
rad.
Swift. She does it a lot.
Interesting. How's Travis feeling?
He's got no tattoos. He's got no tats in those scenes.
Mm.
He looks so much better. You may need to pull up the lyrics. Oh, that's Ethan Hawke.
I love that calling people up has just never gone away for 50 years. It's like the heart of half of every love song. Okay. I feel like I really think you should go first, Aaron.
Oh, great.
should I go first?
Well, I can go first. In the last 10 to 15 years, nobody makes videos better than Taylor Swift. She's the best by far. And whether it's her and her team, I don't know, and I don't really care. This was an extremely well conceptualized video. I love the black and white. That's a little bit different. The introduction of that sort of surreal floating color is something she does a great deal. I did get the analogy and metaphor about, you know, the struggles in life and relationships and wanting to kill the old self, which was what I think the song was about. Kill the negative side of your
good analysis.
Psyche.
I didn't
feelings.
Catch any of the words, but that seems likely.
Well, that's what I heard was in terms of relationships and the part that doubt. Yeah. You know, you doubt yourself, and yeah. it creates storm in relationships and problems and challenges and things. Like she wants to kill her. I think she was talking about herself. Those sort of negative
Nancy.
The negative doubt that. You know, that we carry in ourselves, that each of us do. Mm-hmm. And if I'm right about that, then that's an incredibly relatable topic. And that is why people universally love Taylor, because she's the best right now in the world amalgamizing this.
Look at you.
Yeah, amalgamizing this human condition that we all live in.
Sure.
And put it out there. The song feels extremely familiar to me and is very similar to a lot of her music. I was uninspired by the production and the arrangement of the song. This just sort of soft, echoey vocals that she's doing, and there's no cadence in the song. There's no up and down in her vocals. I don't feel any passion coming from her. It feels very robotic. And I know she's not the strongest vocalist, but this is why I'm not particularly care about
like
her music,
there.
Man.
You like those Gagas. You
know? I do. I like powerful singers, and she's not
that. It's okay.
And people, that is an observation, okay? It's not saying she sucks.
I think you could clearly state that she doesn't have as powerful a voice as some other female singers.
She just doesn't punctuate a lot of things. She's so understated and reflective.
There's no necessarily insult there. So, like, I think that's
fine. There's no insult. Yeah, but I'm telling you, the Swifties will take it as an insult.
Well, that's fine. What
do you think? Micah is a music producer, so he's very in tune with production side of things.
I love space more and more these days. It allows you to actually kind of push the song more, and you can gain energy from simplicity. So I really enjoyed the overall production of this. I thought it was cool. You know, it's not really an uplifting song, so I won't probably listen to it that much because it's a little bit down. I only sit around with wine and tissue paper so much. I try to keep moving, and this is, you know, it's definitely a having a hard time song. Darren, I have a question for you.
Yes, sir.
What if she actually feels like the victim? Like, what if, as a human being, that is something that she just continues to struggle with?
I hope. Because
a lot of people feel like the victim.
It's a wonderful question, man.
You can be the most successful person in the world and feel like a victim. Like, because other people have other things, like they're narcissistic or they're, you know, overly confident. Like, what if, Darren, she always, because she's deep into relationships not working out, and what if she truly does always feel like the victim?
I'll give you, I love
because
your question,
you
Micah. This is the
wrong.
Difference between our show and every other show where people are like, oh, I just love it and everything is great. Well, it's so boring.
She feels like
I'm going to give you an answer.
So
here's what, for Swifties' sake, I mean this sincerely, I hope that she does. And not because I want her to be in pain, but because I want her music to be authentic. Out on the surface, and I get I'm in marketer. Out on the surface, she seems to be an incredibly happy, successful, living her best life, human being. No. I'm talking about what you see in the news and media and cuss like that.
She doesn't come across
and her as mean. Art, I don't get that at all. I hope that Taylor Swift is genuinely happy on all levels. I really do mean that. I worry for Taylor Swift, quite frankly, because she seems to be feeling upset quite a bit in her art. And I would never say anything stupid like, you got a perfect life, just don't worry, be happy. That's dumb, and I would never say that. But I hope that Taylor is okay, and I would like to see some of her okayness reflected in some of her art. And I don't know this, and I have no reason to believe this, if she's a genuinely, for the most part, functional, happy person, and then she puts out these more reflective, sadder songs for the sake of commerce, that annoys me. I'm not accusing her of that, but I'm saying if that's the case, that bugs me.
Yeah.
Because I like authenticity in music.
I mean, I
love this conversation, by the way. No one's going to watch it, but
I love authenticity.
We have a section called Talking Taylor. I'm going to put it just in that.
There we go. I don't think by any means, like when I think of Taylor Swift, I don't necessarily think of a happy person.
Really? I do, man.
No, I just look at those.
Every time I interview her, she seems to be like, pretty good mood.
Yeah, but that just like.
I know,
like,
she's on, she's working just, then.
Yeah, they feel put on. But like when I've watched interviews or more personal style stuff, which you say you've noticed and been like, I think that's authentic. Well, I think you think that a lot of Taylor is inauthentic, and that's kind of where you're coming from. But I have found some of her, like when she's talking, it seems to be a little more realistic, where it's like, I think, it's like you give, we give Billie Eilish a ton of credit. Like we think Billie Eilish is genuinely struggles with insecurities or depression.
And I know that because she talks about it a great deal.
Yeah.
I don't see Taylor doing that. No,
do
I
we follow Taylor
it.
Though? Yeah. Do we like,
I think it's it's impossible to not
follow
Taylor.
I'm going to start following her more. It's impossible to
do I pay attention really closely? No, I don't.
It's impossible to not follow the media's output of Taylor. But I think we should both go follow Taylor Swift, Aaron, for 2 weeks. See how it turns out?
Okay, I'm down with that.
I love it. This is awesome. All right, everybody. I really enjoy this. It's just a little slow for me, so there's not a lot of moments, so I'll put it on.
We didn't figure out why it was called Fortnite, though. But I'm sure it has something to do with 2 weeks.
She said it a million times, and it said 2 weeks all the time.
Someone's going to say, put on the closed caption and read the lyrics. We can't do that with our system. Calm down, everyone.
Actually, we could now. But I don't know. I feel like it takes away from what we're trying to do. We're trying to get just a brief overview, catch a few words, catch the moment, stay inside the music. There's not a person in the world that can.
You can't do that while you're driving in the car.
Yeah, there's not a person in the world that can listen to a song one time and catch the music video, the lyrics. You gotta have 20 of those. This is a reaction. That's why we're reacting. It's how did it make us feel? What did we catch along our first journey? And then, sometimes we end up going
great
back.
Great job on the video, guys, by the way, both Taylor and
it was
Posty.
Awesome. Yep. And I like the song, too, a lot. Yep. If I'm going for a slow, cloudy walk, I will put this on. Until next time, smash.
Subscribe.
Jeez. Smash the subscribe.
Ring notifications.
Somebody help me. Get me out of this nutshell. Ring the notification bell. Come tag along. Comment on here. Be nice to each other. Just be nice. Until next time. Later.